What do you think, Dick? New competition, same success? Let's hope so, because the loser gets to watch from the stands after this third-round game between the Hoftra Pride and the West Virginia Mountaineers.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Mountaineers should have an easy one tonight, Dick. How do they keep this team from sneaking up on them, though?
Hey, here's my keys for them tonight. First of all, set good interior screens to free up your big men on the block. Look to the inside first. Second, make good decisions with the rock. Don't turn it over, baby. Lastly, get busy battling for the boards. Winning teams always rebound well.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Working it around the perimeter, trying to feed inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Tries for two, perfectly executed. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
For two. Makes it. The shooting guard receives the pass. Way off target. For the bucket, he gets that one to fall. Right at the circle, gets it to fall. Looking for a good shot. Entry pass in the paint. Up, easy one. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. He intercepts it, pushes it up. The crowd really admires this young man.
The people here really appreciate what he brings to the table.
Here's a flash from the high post. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
There's the trap.
He lets it fly. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
They look to get it to the inside. And numbers going the other way. Tries for two. He hits the shot. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
They move it into the front court. For two.
Shot inside off the screen. Just move, go. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Dumps it in. Number 45 handles the pass. From beyond the arc. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Number 11 handles the feed.
Try to go inside.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Had a guy in the post, but elected to reverse the ball. There's a double team waiting there. Moving it around the perimeter. He looks for three. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nessler. Horrible shot selection.
Kicks it out. unloads, off the rim and no good. An absolute stranglehold by the defense so far tonight.
Hey, the other team is responding by throwing up quick shots, which is exactly what the defense wants.
For the bucket, they still don't score. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Number 45 is whistled for the foul. Second personal foul. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Dickey's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man. I'll tell you, really a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Number 14 is charged with the foul. First team foul. This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Free throw is good. There they come with a double team to stop it. Number one with the fake. Controlling the ball. Got an open look if he wants it. Looking for a good shot. He throws it up from downtown. Way off target. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Can't put it down. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. They work the perimeter. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
How about this?
Two, and he missed. Number 22 takes it away. On the outside, number 11 receives the ball. Basket falls despite the contact. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
For two, can't get the shot to drop. Tries the turn and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
For the bucket, perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. Jumps into the defender. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. On the outside. He up fakes. He puts up the three ball. Off the rim and no good. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there. Up and inside.
From downtown, scorches the net. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Hoftra are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
He's definitely hogging the ball like you hog the microphone.
Hey, sure he is. I can hear snorting from here.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
The skip pass is picked off. Now they work it around the perimeter. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Gave it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. A defensive player beats him to the spot.
Looking for a good shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Too physical. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. Foul charge. Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
Now they'll bring it up. Shoots from downtown. He buries the shot. There's the pick. On the low block, number one draws the personal.
If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Hits the second shot. Went away from the post and goes the other way. Launches the three. Gets it to go. Gave it up. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Pull-up jumper from way out. He gets the bucket. In the paint. Count that as a personal foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
The post flashes up high if he wants it. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Stop the circle, they work it around the perimeter. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I think a great job by the defense not allowing them to make that turn.
Number 25 comes in for his first go-around tonight, Dick.
I tell you, the offense doesn't miss a beat when this guy comes in.
On the inside for two.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. He misses badly on that three-point attempt. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Very poor positioning on the double team there, Dick.
These kids know better. We'll see if they get it right next time down. Up and inside.
Takes the pass in the paint. Trying to draw some contact.
With plays like that, you need instant replay.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Great anticipation defensively.
On the dribble, gives it up. From way outside, way off target. Long arm trying to get him in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside though is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
In the paint.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Off the rim and no good. Pass, it's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? The Prides have a mismatch in the post.
Can we get him the ball, though?
He puts it up. Way off target. At the half, the Mountaineers are trailing by two. Thus far, it's been a tightly contested game. Dick, what's your highlight of the first half?
Watch some of the great inside work of the first half, Brad. The trick is whether or not they can keep going inside like that in the second half.
Second half about to get underway. Let's go down to the action. Hoftra gave us a three-ball lesson, Dick, in that first half.
I'll tell you, a mighty lesson it was. I expect to see more of the same in the second half.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. They work the perimeter.
Poor job offensively. I'm coaching, he's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball with a deck. Where's he going?
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Gave it up. Puts it on the floor and up and under. In and out. The power forward takes the feed. Goes up for two. He misses it. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
He shoots from the top of the key. Off the mark. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I think doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Number one is fired up and ready to go.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. Here's a drop step, the low block.
Very keys to get good post position, and he does, and then he drops the step over the run.
For the bucket, and off the mark. For the deuce.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
He shoots from long range. Off the rim and no good. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing them to make that turn.
Here's a double team. Stolen away. Goes up for two. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
I'm sorry, Brad, but this young fella seems to be their only hope at the moment.
The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
He comes up empty. In front to take it away. Gave it up. Looking for a good shot.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He attempts a jump hook.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
The point guard gets the ball. Arm and foul. You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all had good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt play is.
Defensively, they keep limiting their chances.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
It's no good. Great defense. The point guard takes the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. He shoots from right of the circle. Makes it.
That's worth another look.
Puts it on the floor and up and under. And in and out. The defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out, and that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
Nice high post screen.
Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Gave it up. Steals the pass. He shoots from the top of the circle. Way off target. Intercepted. The small forward with the ball. I can't believe there wasn't a whistle on that one.
Yeah, it should have been a whistle right there. I thought there was definitely an offensive charge.
We get ready to bounce back into action here. The dribble, gives it up, picks off the lazy pass. They're working around the perimeter. He got busted for three.
He was watching, not playing.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Those are the types of plays you want a lot of. These kids are on a roll. Look at them celebrating with one another.
Hey, can you blame them, Brad? They're playing well.
From the baseline. He gets it to fall.
How about an instant replay?
It's stolen. They push it up on the break. He drains the bucket.
Didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He takes it away. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. They're 15 to 17 feet apart.
Working around the perimeter. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Now the high screen. He can't get the bucket to fall. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it.
Let him right at the screen again. What did I say?
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Oh, what a great job transition. Offense, poor job defensively. Don't get back, don't stop the ball. And they're allowed to convert, get the number game going.
He squares up down in the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up to get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Shot to drop. Working it around the perimeter. In the paint. He fouled him. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Gave it up. Picked out of the air. The point guard gets the pass.
Up and inside.
For two. And he missed. Ball kicked out from the post. He shows the sweet touch.
Let's take a second look.
Dribble, gives it up. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Jumped in front to take it away. Pushes it, picks off the pass. Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. Number 25 fakes the shot.
There's the trap.
Shoots, rims out. Definitely a foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He intercepts it. Moving it around the perimeter. There's a double team waiting there. Strips the ball. And back they come the other way. Buries it home. Well, partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
You've got to love these close wins, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
He fires from long range. Goes in.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He rejects it. Steals the pass. Kicked out from down low. He shoots from outside, off the rim and no good. And the ball goes out of bounds. I think it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing, they're getting good shots and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
Shot clock. Time expires on the shot clock.
That's fantastic D, Brad. What happened was that the defense took away every conceivable good look at the basket.
Dick, what do you do with a 7-point lead?
Yeah, they keep playing and continue to do what's gotten them this far, Brad. Can't change now.
working around the perimeter. Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here. And yet another foul. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Stops the clock again. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love it. At the foul line. No doubt about it. Misses the second. They'll take a timeout right here. Do you think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
The Mountaineers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this part of the game, and the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
And there's a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, knowing when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their teams.
Hits that one. He makes the second shot.
The lead is up to 8.
They could be starting to pull away here, Dick.
Look at that spacing.
With a deep shot from outside. Oh, yes.
Coach looks on. Focused. A lot of intensity. A lot of emotion.
He'll visit the charity strike. Makes his first. Second shot is no good.
If they want a chance to win, they really need a bucket here.
He pulls the trigger. Off target. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ball game.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
Misses his first shot. Makes his second shot.
Everybody TO, baby.
Get ready to resume the action. He puts up the tray. Rims out. For the deuce.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I'll tell you, they won this game, Brad, and you look at it and analyze it because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
the pride. Just wanted it a little bit more in this game, and because of that, they're going to live to play another day, Dick.
Hey, they're on their way to the Elite Eight, Mr. Nestler, where they'll be joined by the 7 best teams in the nation.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler saying so long.